Hello, welcome to the statistics second part class, the analysis of variance, the ANOVA technique. Today I would like to discuss the simplest model of ANOVA, one-way ANOVA, one-factor variable ANOVA. We discussed that in the lecture how the data are organized in a two-dimensional array. We group them by the columns called treatments. Treatment would be my driving factor, driving input independent variable. For example, in drug development research, the treatments could be different age group reacting to a certain drug. In stock market could be different index numbers, different stocks. In logistics, the treatments could be the driving factors for the demand and supply. So this is your design, this is how you design your model. And in general, it is unbalanced experiment, which means the number of the measurements in each treatment is not the same. So it's not a rectangular array. It is kind of rugged array. So we have data values here. J is the variable for the treatments from 1 to T. I is the variable for the measurements for each treatment. I runs from 1 to different sizes of the treatments. So in each case, it will be Nj in general. For the first treatment, will be N1, number of the readings, measurements. Second treatment, N2, and so on. The last one is Nt. What else? This is called an analysis of the variance. The word analysis comes from Greek analyse, which means when you have a problem, you break it down to smaller subproblems. Sometimes smaller elementary subproblems. Elementary means you break them down all the way so you cannot break them down anymore. The smallest possible subproblems, and you analyze them separately. So if we talk about variance, we really need to know the variability depending on the treatment. So how many variances are here? As you can see, when the group you analyze by the treatments, there will be variance within the treatments, or variances, there will be variances between the treatments. That's second kind of variance. Is there any other variance? Yeah, actually there is another third component of the variance. That's the variance between each individual observation and the grand average. The grand average, the sum of all the values all over the array divided by the grand total, big N, the total number of the elements. Double summation, we discussed that double looping process by the columns and rows and columns. I don't want to go into those details now. And the grand total, just the sum of all the sizes of all the treatments. One summation of Nj is the size of the J treatments. J runs from 1 to T. The total, the grand total number of the elements. So those are the three variances I just mentioned, three possible variances. Let me use different colors and to show them here on the board. How can we visualize them? SSTR, sum of squares for the treatments. We discussed it in the lecture. So I look at the differences between the average of the treatments and the grand average. So that's this green variability, yeah? Take those differences, I square them, you know why I square them. I don't want to go into those details. Sum them up. Sum of the squares for the treatments. There is a weight here, I'll talk about it a little bit later. Next component. Sum squares for the error, some was planned for the simple error, SSE or SSSE, different books, different books. And here we look at the difference between each individual observation, Xij, and the average of the treatment, corresponding treatment. Let me use the blue color. So this would be the differences in blue. I take each individual observation within the treatment, compare them with the average of the treatment. And I do it the same way for each treatment. Yes? Take those differences, square them, add them up. The double summation, yeah. But then moving along the column, then along the row. And SST, the sum of squares for the total error, that's the difference between each individual observation and the grand average, which is the difference each individual observation, the grand average, since in orange. Yeah. So those are all possible variabilities in one-way ANOVA. That is the simplest model, the analysis of variance. Three components of the variances, they kind of have a rectangular, kind of rectangular relationship. Yeah. SSTR plus SSE and SST. If you look at the kind of vectors and sum of those two vectors, SST, or difference, whatever. What else I would like to mention? For the sum of squares of treatments, we multiply each difference by the MJ, that's the size of the treatment. Why is that? It's the weight of the difference. Really, we need to look at this variability depending what kind of treatment is coming from, the size of the treatment. Let's say if it's variability of 10 from the size of 5 measurements, variability of 10 from the size of 1,000 measurements, weigh differently. So they're not the same. We have to take them into account differently. That's why we are using the weight for those treatments here. We discussed this concept of grouping data with weights, but we do not have weights here. Why? They don't mention that in the book, really, because of double summation here. We take each individual element from the array here. All the elements are exhausted, all the sizes are already taken into account here. That's why there is no point of introducing weights here rather than for the SSTR, where we really need to take those differences with the corresponding weights to really to get the picture of the variability. I hope that's clear. So let's go down to business. This is what happens in this simplest case, the analysis of variance. SST is equal to SSE plus SSTR. The total variance consists of those two components. I came across your YouTube posting, guys, and you demonstrate this relationship by using real data values here. You calculate those components separately and you verify showing that SST is equal to SSE plus SSTR, which is correct, but that's not a proof. Maybe in other sciences, when you simulate experiment, test the experiment, validate the experiment, they call it, we proved it. In math, that's not enough to prove it. To prove it in math, it should be shown logically, analytically, in general, using formulas, sometimes closed formulas. By using the numbers, that's not a proof, it's just validation. So when we use computer software, simulate the results, that's called quality assurance, validation, but it's not a proof. Some people call it proof, which is not correct. I will prove it now. Again, there are not many proofs. I haven't really seen proofs. There are a couple of proofs from Google that prove it really briefly. Don't go into detail. I will try to show it more in detail. So we start from SST. We defined it as a double sum in our lecture. J runs from 1 to T, the outer loop for the treatments. The measurements run from I to and J, the size of the treatments within the measurements within the treatments. And all the differences, square, some of the squares, the differences between individual observations and the grand average. There are no indices for the grand average, of course. It's only one and only one value for the whole array data. So how about we split it into those two components? If you look carefully, those two components, there is x dot j bar present there, which is not here. So I need to use x dot j bar somehow here. How would I use it? You know, algebraic trick. If we introduce that value to preserve the result, we need to subtract the same value. So this is what I will do. I can rewrite this as the double sum xij minus x dot j bar plus x dot j bar and minus x double bar squared. So those are two my original values. Minus plus the same value cancel out. Why did I do that? Looks kind of messy, but I really need to use that term because it's present. It is present in those two components. So I need to split my SST somehow into those two components. Now it's a simple algebra. You all know it. It's a square of the sum. Yeah, you can treat those two differences as two terms. Square, perfect square of the sum. So it expands into the double sum J1 to T, I1 to M, J, X, I, J, minus X dot J bar squared. That's the square of the first term under the double sum, yeah? Under the double sum. What's next? Twice the product and the square of the second term. So I will regroup it, separate it into a double sum. Plus, we continue the next line, plus this double sum, twice the product, 2xij minus x dot j bar, x dot j bar minus x double bar. J runs from 1 to t, I runs from 1 to n, j, twice the product, and plus the square of the last term, the square of the term, yeah? Let me write it this way. At this point, I don't want to confuse it too much, but the square of the last term, everything is under the double sum, yeah? So let's look at the first component, and that's exactly SSE, you see? So we just filtered out first component SSE. So this is exactly SSE component here. Yeah. So this is SSE component. So we can rewrite as SSE plus, so which means this is my SSTR. Almost halfway done. I need to show that this is SSTR. Let's use algebra here again. Double sum. I will extend this square and remove parentheses. You call it FOIL. It's not really FOIL. It's a distributive law. We'll use this technique to remove all the parentheses. You know that from algebra. You all know this. And here I have two product, xij by x dot j bar, yeah? Minus two, the product of the inner terms, x dot j bar by x dot j bar. X dot j bar actually squared, yeah? X dot j bar squared. Another minus two, xij by x double bar, xij, careful, it's really easy to misspell here. So minus two, xij, x double bar. And the last is minus plus two, x dot j bar by x double bar. Yeah. Done with this, and the square of this difference, you all know it, which is plus x dot j bar square, yeah, the j bar square minus twice the product x dot j bar, x double bar, and plus x double bar square, yeah. But everything is under my double summation. Now let's see, we have here like terms, some algebraic simplification. You see any cancellations here? Plus two x dot j bar x double bar minus two x dot j bar. Those two terms disappear. They cancel out. Plus and minus. Two, yeah. What else? X dot j bar squared, x dot j bar squared, minus two x dot j bar squared, plus one x dot j bar squared. Yeah? Simple algebra. The next line is equal to SSE plus the double summation. J runs from one to T, I runs from one to N, J. What's left there is two xijx bar dot j, next, minus two x dot j bar squared plus one x dot j bar squared. So minus just x dot j bar squared, yeah? I'm done with those two terms. So what's left here, minus two xij x double bar, and the last one, x double bar squared. This everything is under the double summation. Next, SSTR, I'm trying to find out that this is SSTR, is one summation. There is an inner summation using I index here. I need to get rid of it, yeah. What does it mean? Let me just extend it using my I index and just leave only this one sum. Expand the summation. So it will be equal to SSE plus one summation. J runs from one to T. And now my I runs from 1 to nj, so many iterations up to nj. So the first one will be 2x 1 j x dot j bar minus x dot j bar squared. No, I here, there's I here, minus 2x 1 j x double bar plus x double bar squared. This is I1. And I need to cycle it. Next for I2 will be x2 j x dot j bar minus x dot j bar squared minus 2 x2 j x double bar plus x double bar squared. This is I1, this is I2. Yeah, and so on. Many iterations up to the last one when I is equal to mj. So it will be 2x mj j x dot j bar x dot j bar. That's my last iteration for the I minus x dot j bar squared minus 2x mj j x double bar plus x double bar square. Yeah, this everything is an expansion of this inner sum using I index. Now let's think about grouping here. What we can conclude from this? There are common factors, like summing, grouping all those terms. 2x dot j bar is a common factor. Just can factor it out. What's left inside will be just sum of those elements, x1j plus x2j and so on, plus x and jj. What is that? This is exactly first index changes. Second index is fixed j. So if you're moving along the column within the j treatment, it's actually the sum of the elements within the j treatment, either the second treatment or the third. It's just summing those elements up. And they're related to these averages, to those averages of the treatment. So the sum of those, it's actually average of the treatment multiplied by the nj, the number of the elements of the treatment. Just recall this. The x dot j bar is equal to the sum ij elements mj, yeah? Sum of all the ij elements. My j is fixed, so I changes from 1 to mj. J is fixed. So this is what I have here. I changes from 1 to mj. Sum of those elements is equal to the product of those two. The average with by the number of the elements in the tree. So I can write this as SSE plus 1 summation J1 to T. So 2 out X dot J bar out. And the sum of those x's is actually x dot j bar by mj, yeah? And there's another x dot j bar, so the x dot j bar squared by mj, yeah? Done with this grouping. What about those? Minus, minus, minus nj times, yeah? So minus nj times x dot j bar squared. Minus 2 x double bar. Here I have the same thing. X1j, x2j, up to xnj. The same thing, the product of those two. So it will be x dot j bar, x dot j bar, by mj. And the last one, x double bar squared, x double bar, x double bar, how many times? Nj times, plus nj times x double bar squared. Yeah, look at this. What we have here, nj is a sum. Like terms, yeah. Like those two, like terms. let's combine them. So 2 x dot j bar squared and j minus 1 x dot j bar squared and j. 2 minus 1, it's just 1. Yeah. So you can just combine those two and write everything. So rewrite those two terms as, oh, let me do it in the next line. Okay. So SSE plus the sum j from runs from 1 to t. Here I have x dot j and also nj. It's a common factor. Let me take it out. Nj out. So here will be x dot j bar squared minus 2 x dot j bar x double bar, and j is out, and plus x double bar squared, and j is also out. Look at this, what we have inside. You know, you all know that it's a perfect square formula, the difference, yeah? So it's equal to SSE plus 1 summation j from 1 to t and j out, and here it's just x dot j bar minus x dot j bar minus x double bar squared. This is it. Look at this. What is that? We just got exactly SSTR. You see that? This is my SSTR component. So it is really, it really splits out into those two components. I started out from SST, transformed it using algebraic, elementary algebraic operations, and I just equal all the way, and I just showed that my SST is exactly equal to the sum of those two variances, errors, SSE plus SSTR of those squared variances, errors. So this is actually the end of the proof. It's shown algebraically, in general, using formulas, logically. I hope that's clear. It was informative, useful, and you definitely enjoyed that. Thank you very much. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.